Hi, welcome to an Arduino tutorial from Robojax. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can get extra 5 volts from a board, something like this, which has only 1 5 volts, or it has limited 2 grounds or 3 grounds, and you want to get extra ground and extra 5 volts. You can get the code by clicking at the link which is below the description, which will take you to robojax.com/learn/Arduino. Let's get started with this. In many applications, you will face a challenge that your devices, LCD, sensor, or something else that need extra 5 volts. And you see here that it has only 1 5 volts. If you want to get extra 5 volts, for example, the number of ground, we have 2 here and 1 here. And I have another module, for example, this has 5 volts and another 5 volts. In this case, we have 2 here and 1 ground here. So if you want to get extra 5 volts even in this board, and extra ground in that board, or Arduino Nano or any other Arduinos, I'm going to show you in this video. But keep that in mind, that the main VCC of this Arduino Uno can supply up to 400 milliampere. But if you define this digital pin as an output, either for ground or VCC, keep that in mind that it can supply up to 40 milliampere. To understand 40 milliampere, you have to use data sheet or maybe multimeter, but generally majority of the sensors, they consume less than 40 milliampere, except some relay. If you draw more current, you might damage this device. Here we can use a digital pin here from this side as 5 volts. So keep that in mind, and if you need less than 40 milliampere or up to 40 milliampere, this trick that I'm telling you will work. Otherwise, you have to use a breadboard or something like this. Bring 5 volts from there to here, and then you will have extra 5 volts. Let me now show you the code. Here is the code. First, we define a pin. We call it VCC2. So because the first one is the main 5 volts, and the second one we call it VCC. The 5 is also called VCC, so I call this VCC2, and we define a pin here. The pin is, I use pin number 5. Any other digital pin that you wish, you can use. You can use any of these pins except the last 2, and except the last 2 on this side. Anything that has number here, 2, 3, up to 13, you can use it. And then we define also a ground in case you need extra ground. So this also will be pin 2, will be as a ground. After defining a pin number, then we will not use a 5 and 2 as a number. We will use this text so it will be easily understood. Inside the setup, this will run only once. Inside whatever is inside the loop, it will be multiple time. Inside the setup, we say pin mode. We define the mode of the pin, and we put VCC. This is as if I type here 5, so you just change there. This will be changed because it has been used twice or maybe multiple times. So we see the VCC2 as output. So now this pin is defined as an output. After that, we have to set the status of the pin. We say digital write, because the pin is digital. We say VCC, as if I type 5. High means in digital, high mean 5 for this device. And that's it. So you will get 5 volts. And then we define also, we just repeat the same thing here, this time GND2 or ground 2. So this is as if I type 2 as an output. We define the pin as an output, and then we set the status of the pin as low. That low mean ground. So now you can use pin 2 and pin 5 as VCC and ground. The rest of your code, whenever you have a sensor or something, that will go here, and you can use those 2 pins to get extra power. And now here is, for example, this relay module, and this needs 5 volts as a power supply. And this has been labeled here as VCC and ground. So on the left side, this red is VCC. I'm going to connect it to pin 5, and then this one to pin 2. So this is now connected to pin 2 and pin 5. And let me upload the code. Now I'm uploading the code. As soon as the code uploads, you should see that this light will turn on. As you can see, this is now turned on and I have power here. Let me, for example, you have this module and you need 5 volts, and the pins have been labeled here as ground, this gray, and then this pinkish or purple. This purple is VCC. So let me put the purple into 5 volts, and here is a pin, and let me put the this one to pin 2. And as you can see now, this is turned on. It doesn't have signal, but it is on now. Here, this is another example. I put an LED anode is connected to this resistor, and the cathode is connected to this wire like this, and I want to turn this on. So I will connect the anode to 5 volts to my pin 5, which is 5 volts, and then this one I will connect it to pin 2. And now the LED is getting 5 volts from here, and the resistor is reducing it around 2.2 for the LED. And if you need higher current, use a breadboard, and I'm connecting it this red to the 5 volts. And on the breadboard, this line is all connected as one piece from top to bottom, and this is another line, and they've labeled it with color, so you can connect this 5 volts, for example, in here, and all this line will be now 5 volts will be available. You can connect to your devices. And the same way for the ground, I've connected it to the ground, and this will be connected to the second wire, and this will be all ground. And the same way you can do it on this side. For example, if you want to test this relay, this red is the VCC and this is the ground, and I'm connecting it. I will connect it to VCC in here. Any of those wire will be fine. And this one, any of this second wire line. So if I connect it, now this is powered up because all of this will have 5 volts. And also this powered up this way. That's it. This was how to get extra VCC and extra ground from Arduino Uno, Nano, and any Arduino. If you like this video and learn something, please thumb up. I have a lot of other videos related to Arduino. Please check them out by clicking in the link, which is the description. And you will see tons of other codes that I've written and tested. Don't forget to subscribe so you can get updates of my upcoming videos.